Thank you for watching this video from KingswaySoft. Today, I will be introducing the SSIS Integration Toolkit for Microsoft Dynamics SL. This toolkit is a high-performance data integration solution that works for Dynamics SL, utilizing Microsoft SQL Server Integration Services SSIS capabilities. In today's demo, I will show you our software running in a SQL Server 2012 environment. If you are using a different SQL Server version, the interface might be slightly different. To get started, let's create a simple SSIS project. This tutorial will already assume that you have installed the SSIS bits, otherwise you will not be able to see the SSIS project type here. In the Business Intelligence template, select the Integration Services project and give your project a name. Press OK to create the solution. SSIS is a platform that can be used to implement data migration and integration solutions using its drag-and-drop capabilities. To begin the SSIS implementation using our toolkit, we will configure the Connection Manager to facilitate the connection to the Microsoft Dynamics SL server. We will start by creating a new connection in the Connection Manager area to establish a connection to the SL web services. In the Add SSIS Connection Manager dialog box, select the Connection Manager for Dynamics SL and press Add. In the General page under the Server Information section, you would want to specify the SL service URL, where you would enter the address of the location at which your Dynamics SL web service is located. You would then type in your SL company name. In the authentication area, the username, password, and domain allows you to enter the credentials required to connect to the SL server. There is also an option to enter in a timeout for your connection. The value specified indicates the number of seconds before a web service call will time out. The default value is 120 seconds. If we navigate over to the Advanced Settings page, there is an option for retry on intermittent errors. When this option is selected, it will attempt to recover from possible intermittent outages or disruption of service so that the integration does not have to be stopped due to temporary networking issues. We have designed this option so that it should retry when it is deemed to be safe to do so. The culture setting, which contains a default value, is used as a parameter by the Dynamics SL web service. You may need to change this value if your Dynamics SL is configured with a different culture setting. The login service endpoint setting allows you to specify the SL web service endpoint that is used for login purposes. You have the option to specify the full URL or the service endpoint name. At this time, only the login Windows endpoint is supported. You may also enter your proxy server information if you are behind a proxy server. Finally, there is a test connection option. You may click this button to see if a connection to SL can be successfully established. From our control flow view, we will drag and drop a data flow task. We will now go into our data flow view. Our next step is to use the data flow components offered by the SSIS Integration Toolkit for Microsoft Dynamics SL. If you're using SSIS 2012 or later, you will automatically see our data flow components. If you're using SSIS 2008 R2 or earlier, you would need to manually add these components to the SSIS data flow toolbox. I will pull up the SQL Server Business Intelligence Development Studio to display this. Now, right-click on the toolbox and select Choose Items. Click the SSIS Data Flow Items tab and select the Dynamics SL Destination and Dynamics SL Source component. Once again, make sure that you're in the Data Flow view to see these components in the toolbox. Let's go back to the SSIS 2012 environment. In the SSIS toolbox, you will see the Dynamics SL source and destination components. The Dynamics SL source component can be used to read data from the SL server, while the SL destination component can be used to write data to the Dynamics SL server. We will now drag an SL source component from the SSIS toolbox to the design surface. Double-click to open the configuration editor. Specify the connection manager. I will use the one we just created. You would now have to specify your service endpoint. The following are the default service endpoints that are provided by the Dynamics SL Web Services. We will select the customer service endpoint. The batch size by default is 500. This means that we will retrieve 500 records per web service call. The available source objects depend on the service endpoint chosen. For this particular service endpoint, let's select customer as our source object. Some source objects may have child objects. Let's select contacts as our child object. Notice that there are filters for source object and child object. Please note that if you would like to filter any source objects or child objects, you would filter the respective query. If we navigate over to the columns page, we will see the list of available fields for the child object that has been selected. If no child object has been selected, the list of fields will come from the parent object. Note that there is also a refresh component button. This feature is used when you would like to retrieve the latest metadata. We will write the output to a separate text file. Let's drag a flat file destination component to the design surface. We would now configure the flat file destination component to write the data into. Now we will execute this task. All the data from the source component will be copied over to the flat file as defined. This data flow task demonstrates the SL source component. Let's go into SL and delete all the contacts with a customer ID of CR10. We will now look at the SL destination component. To demonstrate this, a new data flow task will be created to illustrate the migration from a flat file source component to the SL destination component. We will retrieve data from the text file that we just created in the first data flow task. We will then write back to the SL server using the SL destination component. Once a flat file source configuration is done, we will drag the SL destination component from the toolbox onto the design surface and connect the upstream pipeline component to the SL destination component. Once we open the destination editor, we will first configure the connection manager. Let's now select the customer service endpoint. As you may have noticed, the available service endpoints are rather limited here. In some cases, you may have to write your own web service interface. If so, you would manually enter in your service endpoint here that points to the web service that you have developed and deployed. In addition, KingswaySoft offers professional services in developing your own web service on a case-by-case basis. As you can see, there are three different action types. There's the create, update, and delete. Let's select the create action. Let's now select the customer for the destination object. The component is able to detect the primary key field, which is customer ID in our case. You can also click the dropdown to specify the primary field manually if you would like. Now we will select the contacts as our child object. Once again, the primary key field for the child object has to be automatically detected. We will navigate over to the columns page in the destination component. The fields are automatically mapped based on a name match. You can choose to map or unmap a field depending on your business requirements. Note that there is also a refresh component button similar to the Dynamics SL Source component, which will update the component to the latest SL metadata. The last page is the error handling page, where there are three error handling mechanisms to choose from. The default option is fail on error, where the entire data flow task will fail as soon as an error occurs. There is also the redirect rows to error output, where the error output will contain the failed records with three extra columns: error code, error column, and error messages. The ignore error option is generally not recommended. We have now completed the configuration for our data flow task. We will right-click and execute the task. Now we will go back to SL and see that the records have been added. This concludes the demonstration of our SSIS Integration Toolkit for Microsoft Dynamics SL. Thank you for watching this video. For any additional questions, please feel free to contact us.